think that what's happening on the streets of protest, what the mayor has said, do you think that that precipitated a gunman to possibly
go first, let me say the mayor did the right thing in asking that these protests stop during this period of mourning. And I just think it's outrageous. There are some of those who still are chanting anti-police rhetoric in this horrible, horrible time. What Commissioner Bratton said a day or two ago is that he believed at the time that this horrible assassination was a, as he's put it, direct spin-off, quote, of the demonstrations. And when you have hundreds of people out on the street saying, what do we want, dead cops? When do we want them now? And this mayor calls them a peaceful protest and meets with those protest leaders, but not with the police leaders. It sends the wrong message. And I think it's just tragic, but I think it also is a reflection of the last 2 years when there has been a concerted effort to demonize this great police force, which is the best trained and, I believe, best operating police force in America.
And this is even before before the mayor took office.
I believe it started during the campaign. Yeah. If you go back to the beginning of last year, this police department was a revered institution here in New York City and across the country. People appreciated their courage, their heroism, and their success. And what happened at that point is there was a primary for mayor. And everybody wanted Reverend Sharpton's support. So it was who could outdo the other in demonizing the police and attacking, in particular, Police Commissioner Ray Kelly. And tragically, that created a terrible climate.
Do you think people around the country understand sometimes what New York City police are up against when you talk about people like Sharpton and you know, people campaigning on it and being political about it? Do you think they understand the day-to-day struggles of New York City police?
I think it's very hard for not just people around the country, but those of us who aren't out on the street, as those police officers are, to understand the tremendous sacrifice, the courage that they show, and the professionalism. They have been responsible over the last 20 years of taking this from the most dangerous city in America to the safest large city,
but you're
saving
not saying
thousands
that,
of lives.
But there are issues that the police department need to deal with. There needs to be reform. The department is not perfect.
No department is perfect, but I do think it is the best trained police department in America, the most respected, and by far the most successful. They have saved thousands of lives through their effective policing policies. And yet, instead of saying, what a great police department we have, which everybody believed across racial or political lines 2 years ago, this effort was made to consciously demonize the police force. And it wasn't just the mayor.
You said that you were, in the initial tweet, you said you were sickened by these barbaric acts. Do you still stand by that?
Oh, it's just horrifying.
Yeah. And what about what Pat Lynch said? Do you think that certainly didn't help, did it?
I think Pat Lynch overreacted in a very emotional way. He's the head of the union. He has sons who are NYPD members. And for all the professionalism, people are human beings. Mm-hmm. And there's going to come a time when their emotion spills out, and it did.
I know you said what you said, but you don't think the mayor should resign, even though you believe he's lost the respect of the police department.
Well, I think our police are very professional. They will do their job, regardless of whether or not they like the mayor. I don't think the mayor should resign. I think he should apologize for so much of the anti-police rhetoric that he engaged in and that he tolerated.